Ideas being transformed into assets through the use of intellectual property rights are a growing source of value in today's global economy. Cross-border payments for the use of intellectual property has seen rapid growth over the past two decades. Intangible assets, which include intellectual property, now account for 87% of the market value of Standard & Poor's 500 companies. Leading tech firms such as Google, Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Amazon, and Samsung are amassing large and valuable portfolios made up of thousands of patents. During the smartphone wars of the last decade, it is estimated that Microsoft may have generated billions of dollars a year from only 30 licensing deals. Large companies not only produce large war chests from their intellectual properties, they are also able to freeze out competitors and new players from the market. With so much at stake, where does Canada fit in? Over the past decade, Canada's patent applications have declined. Canada also pays out significantly more in intellectual property royalties than it collects from abroad. In short, Canada is a consumer, not a producer of innovative ideas. Some have suggested that Canada can address this gap by following the lead of countries such as South Korea, Japan, France, and China to create what's called a sovereign patent fund. In essence, a sovereign patent fund is a state-led investment initiative that acquires and protects intellectual property assets, which are important to national economic objectives. What would a sovereign patent fund in Canada look like? First, it could protect small and medium-sized enterprises from patent trolls. Patent trolls buy up large numbers of often low-quality patents and then try to cash in on them with threats of litigation, which are designed to encourage the operating companies to settle. This protection would help secure freedom to operate for Canadian tech companies. Second, it could prevent what's known as intellectual property flight by rescuing national patents from foreign ownership. Third, it could provide high-level intellectual property expertise to Canadian small and medium-sized enterprises otherwise unable to afford it so that they can start up and scale up. Lastly, it could help small and medium-sized enterprises realize the value of their intellectual property through licensing deals. All of these things working together could eliminate size-specific disadvantages and help transform Canada from a consumer to a producer of innovative ideas. Is this the way forward for innovation in Canada?